Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to another Overwatch game. Northwestern College Esports in their first playoff game of the season. We got a good game for you guys tonight against North Dakota State University. You see the players up there again, the usual roster. We're going to be going into Map 1 Busan here pretty shortly, but I want to thank all of you for joining in for another game, another week of Raider Esports. Going undefeated so far in the season with 3-0s just back-to-back-to-back. We haven't seen anything but a 3-0 so far, so we're hoping to see that again in this first playoff round. If the Raiders win this, they're going over to semifinals, so feeling pretty excited. Pretty big night for him tonight. Let's go into the game and see what kind of team comp we got running. Alrighty, looks like we're on the Junker Queen comp. One of my favorite comps to watch. And that's a little different. We got Vakancho on Moira this time. A little bit of a switch up in the team composition than past weeks. Usually playing a Kiriko here, but looks like even the 3-0 comp has a little bit of change going on every once in a while. Northwestern's taking this first fight, sending NDSU back to spawn and starting that percentage going up. We see the Raiders play this team composition a lot. A lot of it is reliant on picking a right time to fight. Finding the optimal time to go in, and it's usually Ronin, QWERTY, and LBV going in at once on almost like a semi-dive comp where Amino and Vakancho can kind of stay back and poke. But this new Moira change, I'm not sure how well that part's going to happen, so I don't know exactly what the change was because of, but I'm sure that there's good reason to it, because I don't think this team would do anything but the best. Ronan getting pretty low here. He's hacked. The Sombra is just focusing him, but he's playing this cover real well. LBV just staying on heals, making sure his team has that little healing over time. While Moira Vakancho can take care of most of the big heals that are needed. No deaths so far. One ultimate coming out from Turbo Turtles on NDSU's side. Like Amino gets hacked, but he's able to stay safe. He's low though, and there he goes. But LBV gets a big kill on the tank with a boop off the edge, and Northwestern gonna be winning this fight. QWERTY going for this last cleanup kill on Turbo Turtles. Not everyone's gonna get it, but he is gonna hold onto his dash and not put himself in a bad spot. Northwestern, four ultimates here with 85% on the point against the one ultimate on NDSU's side. One ultimate for both sides so far. LBV is going to use his. Vakancho's using his also. That's three Northwestern ults. That's four Northwestern ults. And it looks like they got the kills they need. Just a tank online and one support. That's going to be it. Northwestern, although the cap goes to NDSU for 7%, not going to be enough. Northwestern going to take round one of the map here on Busan. We saw NDSU's changing up their team comp a little bit as they have a last-ditch effort to try to capture the point, and they do succeed there, but it wasn't consistent enough to hold on to the point for a good team fight and get Northwestern sent back to spawn. Looks like they're kind of scrambling to find anything, any sort of counterplay to this Northwestern comp that we've seen be so dominant time and time again, game after game. It really is up to these players playing, not necessarily the characters. It's not all about a character swap or what character plays best against Genji or even Junker Queen. But these guys are so meticulous in their timing, in their communication, and in where they are positioned on the map, that it's just hard to find them slipping up and taking advantage of that. Amino getting pretty low, gonna drop back for some heals for the Moira. Playing that far away poke while Lucio and QWERTY going in. There's a kill. Amino finds the headshot on the Lucio. Or just a regular shot on the Lucio. Gets the kill, though. Northwestern, 3 kills there, and they're in deep. Looking for the final cleanup kills, trying to send him back to spawn. And point is getting capped. We got LBV on the point to cap, and Northwestern starting with that percent uptick. LBV looking to have stay on top of this doorway, looking for maybe a boop. Loses it because the NDSU switches up the door they're coming through. QWERTY's in a little bit of trouble. And that could have been a monster boop from LBV, and it sure was. Finds two through that little doorway. That looks like even better than what he was possibly going to get if he stayed on this doorway right here. So a little birthday present there for LBV on not his birthday. Northwestern's ult economy also looking quite strong here. A few in the 80s in the competition. We might see this fight have some ults from Northwestern come out. Not sure if NDSU will get enough charge for one this time. Looks like they won't even need it. It is only at 60% though, so there definitely are some more fights to come in the future. But they're holding on to 4 ultimates now, and NDSU possibly 2 here. Turbo Turtle's gonna get his quite quickly, and Link TJK possibly gonna grab one before during the midst of this fight, but hard to say for sure. QWERTY real low here, gonna need to get safe, goes up to the top. Going for the blade in. Both DPS gone in an instant, both supports gone in an instant! And can he get the... He gets it! The pentakill, the team kill, the team wipe, almost all through the Dragon Blade. Oh my gosh, QWERTY timing that ultimate so well. Gets 2 DPS with 1 slash, gets 2 supports with another slash, and finishes out with the Zarya there. Ronan gonna use his ultimate here. Grabs one of the support players there. Amino and LBV gonna be popping their ults, looking to just close this fight out and get a team wipe here. You don't want NDSU to stall on point for long and let their other teammates come back, but it doesn't look like they'll be able to as the point goes to 100-0 right here. Northwestern with the dub, taking home Busan round 1. Alrighty, play of the game here from QWERTY. It's gotta be the moment we just witnessed. And here it is. Watch it again. Boom, boom, 2 DPS gone. Supports in 1 slash. Has to wait out the Zarya bubble. Doesn't have the blade, but gets the clean shot with the melee to finish up. That's a nice play right there. Alright, Northwestern going up 1-0 in this best of 5 series here. We'll be back with round 2 in just a short moment. Don't you go anywhere. We'll be right back. All right, we are back onto map two, Dorado. We got a payload map for you. The attacking side, it's going to be NDSU first here, is going to try to push this payload cart along this blue line as far as they can on the map. There are two checkpoints until the end point, and that is their Golden Northwestern's job currently is to stop them at all costs. So we're going to see from the defense side of things first. We'll see Northwestern attempt to stop this payload push on Dorado. Ronin on D.Va this time. A lot of verticality in this map. I think that's a good choice, as Junker Queen does not have as much vertical mobility as D.Va does. Got to be watchful of that Winston, though. Can't have anyone on Northwestern's team get picked. LBV looking like a pretty likely target for that, as he is the Zenyatta of the team. Finds a Tracer in the back line, going for some cheeky kills, but looks like QWERTY's gonna meet him there in 1v1. Gets the kill. Slow moving so far. QWERTY in the back line on the Kiriko. Gonna get out, but not as far as he thought he would. Will he be able to escape? And no, he's gone. QWERTY down, Northwestern down, one member of the team. And that respawn is far away. NDSU gonna need to take full advantage of this moment right now to push this payload and get some kills, but Northwestern's playing smart. They're backing up. They're getting far, and LBV gets a nice shot on the Tracer. Not today on the dive for the support. Looks like QWERTY is back as well, so Northwestern back to their full strength and capability here. Just a waiting game as a lot of the team is split up from each other. LBV getting pushed, and it's not gonna work. The Kiriko doesn't have a teleport either. Big damage on the Lucio there from Amino, but not gonna get the kill, and someone's pushing this cart. Looks like QWERTY doesn't like that. Three ultimates up for Northwestern, about one for NDSU here. QWERTY goes for the ult, doesn't get it, but does scare them right into his tank teammate Ronin. QWERTY almost getting ulted, but just backing into a corner, escaping it. Not a lot of big fights yet, not a lot of big ult dumps so far, as NDSU waits to gather their ultimate economy, and Northwestern not wanting to waste an ultimate because this spawn room is so close that any ultimate that gets lots of kills, it buys time, but it doesn't win the game. So they're holding off without using ults as much as they can currently. Ronin just diving onto the soldier and getting that kill, and right back to his perch up here on the top of this building. Gonna send that Winston down. Amino gone, though. Gets sniped by Fire Alpha on the Sojourn swap. That happened without even... I didn't even realize that occurred, but the Sojourn swap probably caught Amino off guard as well. And there goes Vicontro, Northwestern, only four strong as Amino gets back. Gonna have to start popping some ults here, I believe. We'll see who goes first. It's gonna be LBV to save his tank, get some healing in here, and render that monkey useless. Gets the kill as well with a big discord and some nicely hit shots. Sojourn in the back line doesn't find any. Only 20 seconds left to go, and Northwestern's holding on to four ultimates. Ronin just going to take space, not let anyone get any pushes. Possibly even gonna ult here if he needs to. Wait, two ultimates coming out for NDSU. Can anyone touch? Looks like Amino goes down as well after using his ult. Four kills here for Northwestern, only one alive, and it's the Sojourn. Not gonna be able to hold on. Overtime it is. Northwestern with a round one hold again. We've seen that quite a few times this season, not even allowing NDSU to get to that first checkpoint. They are attempting to make it a little easier for them when they go on the attack. I'll explain a little bit about how this game mode works. So Northwestern just finished up on their defense, and they're moving on to attack. They're just going to swap roles here. NDSU will get the chance to defend. Northwestern's going to push that payload, which normally sits right here. And all they have to do is push it as far as NDSU just pushed their payload, which is right here. So if Northwestern can get this much distance on the payload, they'll win the game. It's that simple. The rest of the map, we won't even get to see tonight because there's no need to see it. That will be the end of it. So only a round one map here. For sure on Dorado. All right, these teams are getting ready. NDSU going to set up their defense. Pretty similar team comp here for Northwestern. Some teams will often switch up their defense and attack. Some characters they like better on attack and feel have a little bit more of an aggressive tendency, while other characters are really good at defense. You see a Symmetra over there on NDSU's side, which is generally regarded as quite a defensive character, as she can set up turrets to guard her positioning. But I don't know, Northwestern finds it works to just play the same team comp, attack or defense. They don't really seem to care. All right, a little bit of a free push here at the start. Ronan going, taking this high ground, having a few off angles while they leave someone on payload. It looks to be QWERTY on payload just to poke and keep moving it. But Northwestern has this high ground, which, if you've watched Star Wars, you know the high ground is always the best place to be. Alright, bit of a slow fight here. Ronan going behind. Northwestern just circling around NDSU right now, trying to catch them slipping, one team member to be out of place, but they are playing tight as a group. They're like a tight-knit family currently, all holding hands. Ronan making sure Zenyatta stays alive here. Doesn't want to lose any members of his team. LBV to BLVD on DVD, very low, but a nade and a Discord's gonna take out the tank. Ramatra's gone. Two down for NDSU. And there goes a third, fourth, and possibly fifth. All of them dead. I don't know if the Wrecking Ball is going to be able to make it in time. They are the one fight with the free push that they got at the beginning while leading up to that fight. Northwestern wins. It's that plain and simple. Round two, going over to Northwestern with quite an easy stroll down Dorado Boulevard. LBV has the play of the game here. Gonna be that Ramatra with the big anti-nade that we just saw from his POV just a second earlier. The big sleep dart from Vacancho allowing that all to take place. Sleeping the Ramatra, waiting for the Discord, the charge shot, and hitting with a nasty anti-nade, just allowing him to go down in an instant. Northwestern definitely feeling pretty good right now as they go into Flashpoint, their favored maps of the night. We'll be right back as these teams take a little bit of a breather, find out what the next map's going to be. Don't you go anywhere. We'll be right back. And here we are right back into it. On to Suravasa on the Flashpoint. Northwestern's favorite map type. As this is where it all has ended so far this season. All of their games have been 3-0s and always ends with a Flashpoint. A Fiddle is subbing in for Amino onto the Sojourn here. And while I got you here, as we go into map three, I want to thank Fire Alpha for killing Vacancho. No way, that is not what we like to see. QWERTY's gonna avenge him right there. Gets the kill on Fire Alpha. Make sure that no stone is unturned here. As I was saying, thank our wonderful sponsor, HyperX. That's what all of our team uses here for all of their peripherals, headsets, mice, keyboards, you name it. We got it in HyperX gear. That's what's allowing them to play to this peak ability. So if you are an upcoming high schooler wanting to be a collegiate esport athlete like our team here, get yourself some HyperX gear. That's the best way to go if you want to perform at the top level. Northwestern taking an easy 30% here onto the map, onto this Flashpoint right now. Ronan playing sneaky Junker Queen right now. Seems like he's been found out. Big swing and possibly a kill as he pulls. Vacancho finds a kill there on the Moira, getting good damage with the damage orbs. Healing his team, just consistently being able to provide support for his tank. Might even get this Lucio if the ball goes in the right direction. QWERTY already at ultimate, Ronan at his ultimate as well. I don't think NDSU is going to be able to touch this Flashpoint. We're going to move on to Flashpoint number two here as Northwestern caps this one. Just waiting to see which direction to go, and they're going over to the right. NDSU was ready for it to be over this direction. Looks like they're going to get their first. Northwestern going to have to play the attack game here. They do have those ultimates. And here we see QWERTY go in with the ultimate, finds the Lucio, goes for the Mei as well. He's going to get him. That's two. LBV finds another in all the chaos. Northwestern winning that fight with just one ult dump from QWERTY. Goes for the Mei, waits the ice block out, and finds the Lucio. Wraps around to the Mei, and in the midst of all of it, we have Lucio, LBVDB, LBD on DVD, finding a pick as well. Northwestern gathering that percentage on the Flashpoint already, and it's going up mighty fast. We'll see how many ultimates are going to be needed here. We got a sneaky Ronan looking for an ult, and he's going to get almost all five. Gets four of them. That's a huge ante from Ronan as Northwestern finds three and two of them with their ultimates. And all five double kill gone. Team kill for Northwestern to secure the 50% there. Going to make it only one fight left on this Flashpoint for NDSU if they can get there fast enough. They do have four ults. Are they going to use those ults to try to secure this Flashpoint? Or will they wait until Flashpoint number three? In my opinion, I think you got to dump it now. If you wait till Flashpoint three, it's an all or nothing. You have no backdrop to hold on to. If you dump them now, you still have game to play. Fiddle going to pop his ultimate in response with the Lucio ultimate as well. Finds a kill and gets out with LBV's nice Lucio ultimate to save his team. I don't think Fiddle would have been able to survive that long without it. Vacancho using his just to secure the point. Northwestern, no ultimates. NDSU coming up on three here. They are looking to have to dump all of it into this last Flashpoint. If they don't capture it, that's the game. Playoffs, round one, go to Northwestern. So they're going to be using these ultimates kind of in this last-ditch effort. Northwestern just wanting to hold on to this point. Definitely have quite a bit of a large cushion behind them to fall back into if they need to. But these guys are not known to relax and take it easy and fall into that cushion. They push, push, and push until they can't push anymore. One kill here for Vacancho. QWERTY with an ultimate, possibly. He's in the back line, probably gonna wait out some points, but not gonna need to, as Northwestern, just with their regular abilities, no ults needed, are gonna cap the point again. This is just allowing Northwestern to grab their ult charge while NDSU, three of their players can't get any more ult charge because they're already maxed out at 100%. And this is just beneficial for Northwestern to have as many of these little fights without NDSU using their ultimates as possible. Big ultimate possibility here for QWERTY. Goes in, not gonna use all of it, just goes for the damage, but has a lot of utility against him that he can't survive against. Ronan finds a crazy pick with a knife on fire alpha. Gonna send one back to the spawn rooms and just allow Northwestern to keep gaining that ult charge. Looks like NDSU's back to full strength. Two ultimates here. We've got Junker Queen ult, not gonna hit too many. And the May ult, not gonna freeze any from Northwestern side. QWERTY finds two. Looking for this Baptiste. Just waiting him out and he dies. Full team kill. Northwestern wins. I didn't even realize as there was just so much going on in that last fight. But Northwestern does take it home, another 3-0 on the flashpoint, but more importantly, a 3-0 in the entire game. Play of the game here, that big ultimate from Ronan. Now, if you had some HyperX headphones like our players do here, you might be able to hear Ronan when he's on those sneaky off angles. As sound is so important in this game, and HyperX headphones are the best of the best, allowing you to hear every small footstep made in Overwatch. That's it, ladies and gentlemen. That's the end of the game. Northwestern coming home with another dub in the playoff series. If you stick around, we will have another post-game interview. For all of you viewers who were here last week, I apologize. The stream ended and cut off the interview from last week. I promised an interview and it did never come to fruition, so I apologize for that. But there will be one tonight and it will not get cut off, I can promise you that. Stay tuned a few minutes here while I go grab one of the players to talk on mic. Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen, we are back here with the post-game interview. We've got Vacancho here, one of our support players. Vacancho, how we doing?
Oh, great. Another 3-0 for the books.
Another 3-0, yes. Continue the streak. First round of playoffs. How did the team look at this match going into it, knowing it was a playoff game? Was it same as normal, or was it a little more anxiety, a little more stress on this one?
I'd say we were about the same, but before the match started, we said who was the four seed for our bracket, which was you and I, and they almost managed to take a map off us in our game, so we said, can't give them anything easy.
For sure, yeah, definitely. a smart decision to make sure no team flies under the radar. Everyone's got to have the same competition level. I mean, if you start slacking, you don't know who's going to come up out of the woodworks and start taking advantage. So, Vakantra, I want to ask you about tonight because we noticed a little bit different character from you. We had the Moira a lot of the time with that Junker Queen comp that we were used to you running Kiriko. Yeah. Can you walk us through what's going on with that change?
Coach texted me one night and said, hey, start playing Moira, and I never thought I'd hear it. But I think with Kiriko, you really only get cleanse and a little bit of damage. Her ult's good, but with Moira, you can fade more. You get more damage output, more, you know, possibly more healing output. Or I can heal and do damage, and then obviously her ult is a laser beam.
Mm-hmm.
So whether you're going in hard or they're coming onto us, we can ult and keep healing and damage high.
So subbing out that utility from Kiriko cleanse for a little bit higher damage and healing input is kind of seemingly what the team was wanting.
Yeah, and just I was struggling to hit some shots on Kiriko, especially headshots. That's where her main damage output is. So if I play Moira, just right-click.
Just right-click and hold, and you get damage from far away sometimes, too, with throwing those damage orbs. So you're feeling pretty good about it. You're okay with the team, the comp swap.
Oh, I am all for it. If I can sit back, hold right-click, and hold left-click when I have to, I'm all down for it.
All right, and with only a few more games left in this little tournament we got going, are the team's sights set on Nationals? Is that what we're looking for here, or are you guys just looking towards the next game?
Oh, no. We're already setting sights on Nationals. You know, it's one game at a time, but if you don't have an end goal, I don't think you can have a drive for the next two or three games we have to play.
All right, sounds good. Well, hey, best of luck in those next games. Any last words to our viewers, anyone watching?
No, just thanks for supporting. Glad to have you guys watching, cheering us on, and just be thankful that we don't go to Dort.
All righty. Thank you, Vakantra, for giving us that post-game exclusive interview, which we'll get to our viewers as we won't cut it off early this time. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for tuning in to another Overwatch match. Catch us next week as we go into the semifinals of the tournament, yet to find out who our opponents are for that one. My name is Hades. Peace.